Damson heren, and welcome back to Snowrunner. Yes, it's been a while. Hopefully just about an hour's stream. So as you can see, I've got Across the Riverdon selected, and I think that's something I am probably going to do. Yep, it's probably going to be something I'm going to do. Get this one finished. If I can remember, just have a quick look. So we're gonna go up the road. Yeah, I'm gonna go up the road. I think by looks of it, yeah, we'll turn around, go up the road, and we'll go along to here to get across there. Excuse me. Got enough fuel. Wanna get the camera back? That would have been a disaster. There we go. So, yeah. Go over here. Just have to be really careful with this truck. Tendency to slide and tip and get wedged. Excuse me. I can sort of keep on the rocks. Okay, so that's not going to work. Let it flow a little bit. Fight the current a bit. Get the front up onto solid. Thank you. And we've done. So let's recover this and see what the next one is. Unlucky fisherman. Where's the fisherman's house? Okay, let's actually get this sorted then. So I've got the Azov on fuel in case of backup. Or if it needs it. Which, right now it might. Get a little bit of low range and a bit higher range, quickly switch over. Okay, this isn't good. I've gone the wrong way. I just realized where the watchtower actually is. If I can keep on that bit of the road, I should be alright. Bring myself back here a minute. So the watchtower, I'm gonna have to go up. I think it's up there. Not entirely sure if I can get the Azov up there. Might be able to. Yeah, the Azov will get up here. It should get up here better than this. I've just ditched it. Oof. So that is the fisherman's house and the watchtower's over there. So I'm gonna have to go that way. Probably over there. I can't remember who unlocked this watchtower when we did multiplayer. So yeah, long to. Oh, crap. There we go. And I bet I've just missed the turn. I have missed the turn. Camera, please. There we go. Where the hell is this last watchtower? But that is there. And what are you then? Oh, you're an international transfer. Are you part of a mission? That is. Okay, so I'm there. And that last watchtower is down the other end. So if I sort of bring myself back this way. Bring myself along. Do I tempt fate and get the upgrade? I'll probably tempt fate and get the upgrade. And then come back down and go that way. For now. So if I need my ass off, I'll get it to come give me fuel. Get the camera under control, that would be nice. Ooh, shit. Damn. Okay, so I think the Azov will get over here, but as long as it's not too top heavy. Come on, you stupid Chevy. The upgrade location will be this way. Don't turn the camera around. There we go. Got enough fuel at the minute, so I'm alright. Too much power there. You know what would be quite nice? Adaptive throttle on this. On the dual shock 4 controller would be nice. Alright, let's risk it. Engageable 4. Ah, okay, it's only for the GMC. There we go. Alright, let's go. Carry on. I'm just... I am a little bit worried about bringing the Azov over. Alright, let's go this way. And it's raining. Wonderful. Let's park up a minute and just check. Ah, okay, so it's down there. It's going to be a case of scooting back and jumping there, innit? Okay. Actually, no, I'll just scoot forward. Okay. Right, so I think my work here with the Chevy is done for now. Wrong button. I shall get that later if I need it. I'm gonna actually recover the Azov for a minute. I'm glad it ghosted that. Okay, so unlucky fisherman. I could have gone over. I was always, I was there, so I could have gone back that way. It's going to be interesting to get to be honest. There is an upgrade there, I'll get that later. Okay, so the best way is going to be coming out the garage. Down to the bottom. Down here. Across the dam. To the quarry. So the fisherman's house is there by the quarry. So we're gonna go there. I'm gonna come through. Here. This is the usual route we take when we do all this. We'll come down, get through all this, get as far as there, we'll come out, bring it back slightly, come to there, go down here, take a look at that truck. Run it along there as best we can, probably get that truck, then once we get there I'll plan the route out. So just so you guys can see what is going on. I'll skip a little bit of time. Now, guaranteed, this may not be the best vehicle to do this in. But it's probably going to be the most powerful, and I can use my own fuel. Turn down my ears just a little bit because it's incredibly loud in my ears. So just take this nice and wide. So we did have a bit of issues with Snowrunner the other night, my multiplayer, but we chalk that down to PSN issues. Kind of didn't realise my fleet star was there. Oh, that was because the other... that was there waiting for the other Azov to come back. Sticking in high gear is not going to do any good because, as you can see, it jolts forward. I don't know what it's going to be like for towing. Get around without colliding, yep. So come to that, it's over there. No direct route over there either. This thing isn't quick. I'll admit that. A cruise control option would be nice. Yeah. Oh, come on, game, seriously. That's one mistake you make, you get too close, and that's really annoying with this truck. You get too close to the bridge end, and bang. It's because of the weight. I should use the other Azov. Right, start turning. Interesting, the bat lights stay on. I thought I was on the bridge more than I was. Clearly not. stick it in neutral and just let it roll. Stick it back in automatic quickly. Take two. Should just use the other eyes off, but never mind. The Azoth is powerful, but the only downside to the Azoth, it's pretty slow. Not quick enough. So now I could possibly roll it. I mean, you're right, I'm idling. Not gonna be enough of a slope there. Alright, let's try this again. It's better, it's a bit quieter in cab. You didn't turn quick enough. Or did I? No. Ooh, screw up the sword. I mean, that's got light. It's got lights on the bottom bar, but you don't use them, which is a shame. You should be able to use them. Okay, head into the bridge again. This time I'm more centered on that bridge. Good. Now we're back on. Come back to main road. See, once you've unlocked the bridge, these objects should just disappear, but they don't. Right, there's the fisherman's house. Coming up to the turn in any second. Wow, really? What hit that? Wrong one. What time am I on? Yeah, it goes darker when it starts to rain. This is a bit, I've got to be careful because I could tip. Get it up. There we go. Thank you. camera angle so I can actually see something. Nice and easy. And now onto the bit that I'm used to doing, but then this next bit I'm not used to. No problem. All the air's off. Fuel's looking okay. Just try and keep on a winch point, near a winch point in gears. Let's see where this. I can get a fleet star through. This and this has a bit more grunt, so I don't see why this shouldn't be a problem getting through. Okay. Quick look at the map. So we're pointing. Yeah, pointing straight. Keep it straight. All straight as I can. Because of tree lines and etc. This is probably better to use one of these trucks or an off-road truck to get through. Kind of doesn't like you turning. So this terrain isn't too difficult for it. Get on this stuff. It's fine. Best thing to do is keep on solid and see. No, okay, I'm gonna have to go forward a bit. Which way I'm turning my wheels? Yeah, again, the wrong way. Ah, there we go. I got. I'm just gonna stick a bit of fuel. Didn't mean to do that, but let's give that a bit of fuel. And I'm gonna turn myself around. So yeah, there's kind of that would be a little bit probably risky trying to get it that way. So I'll probably just come back this way with it. Didn't see that other truck, so and then best way to probably take it's going to be back through. Just put a waypoint there. That's probably going to be the best way to do this. Can my winch at the back? Get his front. Yes. Beacons. And then spin you around. I just put the beacons on because obviously I'm towing, but it doesn't make a matter, you can drive with your beacons on all the time. All I want to know is how did he get that thing out here with dangerous water level? That's what I'd like to know. Wonder how we got out of here. This thing needs to get traction, because if I don't want to stall it out. Obviously he's not got that's not got a snorkel on that thing. It's going to be dangerous water level. I don't want to drag this thing any closer, I want to keep it at the level it is. Come on. You can do it. Now knock it back into I don't think it would get up here in high gear. Nope, nearly stalled out. Because I accidentally hit the tree. Knock it back in its normal gear. I know he's gaining on me because I've knocked it into low a minute. Now I'll get the distance on him again. Kick it into high gear. Let's keep this as... Didn't want that to happen. Stalled out. Keep it as straight as I can on the exit. It's out. That's why I didn't want to bring in two claws. There we go. Dumb. Leave that there a minute and find out what this well is. Well, to the spare service hub, so that would require the flatbed. Yeah, could get him across. Go across the farm. Can it be done in the other Azov? Well, we shall do it. Vehicle spare parts, I only need one. So we'll pick up. That's why I'm glad for third person, because at some points in first you can't see. Like now. I don't know, I like using the Azovs. I know they're slow, but they've not, hasn't these two haven't proven me wrong. And as of time of recording this, well, not recording, but well, sort of recording streaming, the new add-on hasn't. Well, the new update hasn't dropped. I like the waypoint system in this game a lot better than I do Mudrunner. So, I'm gonna go left. I'll go down to the Fleet Star and pick up a bit of fuel. And then, yeah, we come up to here, and this is gonna get interesting trying to get the Azov up there actually, but. We'll try it. I've deliberately gone past. because I'm getting some fuel. I'm gonna grab a quick drink so I can stop doing that and just quickly wet my throat a bit. Oh, was the expression we would use, wetting the old whistle. Unless we use that expression for something else, but you know. Just really hasn't tuned my calendar over yet. I'll do that later. Okay, so back into the Azov. Put it in reverse. And we'll head off again. This should be an issue for this to get through here. I'm kind of hoping that that other map isn't bugged, because for multiplayer, because it would be pretty annoying if it is. Because we want to get that new map done, me and David, and then get on with probably coming back and finishing off cleaning up certain things that we were doing. Like maybe Michigan, and try and get Island Lake and all that lot done. And then we've got Russia and Alaska still to do, yeah. We should be alright for Russia. Because we have Russian trucks that we've been using, so this shouldn't be too bad for me to. This won't be too bad for me to get through. He says. It's this bit that's going to be the worry. You'll get up here. Probably. Once I get a decent view. Because I've got glare on my screen. And yeah, not through easy, not from in-game glare either. Come on, I don't think the fleet star would have got up here. It might have done. But it was just sort of easier just running that up. So I'm thinking that one is let's find the antenna tower, lost bags, Michigan Trail. Let's have a look on the task givers. Threatening accident, which is going to need a truck with a crane. That should be too bad. Lost trailer. Need a scout vehicle. And you're not going to get a scout vehicle around there. What you could actually do. Is you could actually get the big vehicle down there, go and get that upgrade. And you could probably. No, you wouldn't. You'd have to come down, bring it down there, and drive along and tow it. If I was using this. Tool delivery is a curtain side trailer. Which is that pain in the ass want to get out of and it's gotta go to the warehouse. Which is doable. And then you've got to pick up two fuel from there, which I'd do it in this one, and it's gotta go all the way. To the forester's house, which is near the drilling site, and then obviously from there to the drilling site, which wouldn't be too bad to do. You just go up and basically sort of come the way you were coming, so you'd have to go around the big one. Don't cut through that little bit because you'll end up tipping. So that's that. And then, yeah. So for now, I'm just going to jump this back to the garage. Park it up here, just to be lazy. And sorry guys, but I'm going to cut this one short because I need to go and get some food. I'm a bit Hank Marvin right now. Yeah. I am. I'm a bit starving. So, yeah. Thank you for joining us. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you're watching on YouTube. If you are watching on Twitch, please give us a follow. It'd be much appreciated. And it keeps you up to date of when we, obviously, do live streams. And yeah, all links will be in the description on YouTube, and you can check out our social media links, which are in the About panel on Twitch. So yeah, thank you for joining me. Until next time, goodbye for now.